How you doing, everybody? It's Eddie over here. New Food Reactions coming at you with some more Lady Gaga buys. Lady Gaga buys. You know, we love Lady Gaga over here. And what do we got today? We're finishing off the Art Pop album buys, the last four songs. All right, so what are we doing? We're doing Mary J. Holland, Gypsy, Applause, Dope. Maybe not in that order. I don't remember, but those are the four names of the last four songs on the album, so we're going to be checking them out. Boss, all right, I'm freaking stoked to be checking this out. Now, after this, we'll be getting on to... It's up to you guys. You guys will have a comment down below and let me know. Do you want me to do some of the live versions of Art Pop before I move on? Some of the more other alternate versions of these songs? Or should I just get to the next album and then when I get all the albums done, just come back and start doing all the live stuff afterwards? It's up to you guys. Either way, if you haven't already, be sure to mash the subscribe button, boys, and the bell notification. You know, come along on my journey as I hang out with me as I'm going on my Lady Gaga journey. And it's freaking fun and freaking awesome, boys. And shout out to my patrons. You guys also love Lady Gaga. I love Lady Gaga. The patrons are freaking awesome. That's all I got to say. Let's just get into it. Let's go. What do we got first? Mary Jane Holland. I had to pull up a lyric video. There's no official video for it. It's just some kind of snippet, 2 minutes. But... Lady of the dumb won't be a slave to the blonde or the culture of the popular. She won't. Okay. Sing it, you, I'll fly under radar tonight. Make deals with every devil inside. She's getting naughty, boys. Okay, I was going to say, she was going on a bit of a rant there, saying she's going to be in naughty girls with hookers and gin and all this kind of stuff. I'm like, all right, Gaga, classic Gaga here, boss. My God, I just noticed the artwork. Look at it. There's tattoos on her chesticles. Anyways, boys, what are we getting on with here? Now, look at this. She's singing about Mary Jane Holland. And so is this song about the whole, certain substance that shall be not named? Oh, it's probably going to be named 100 times in this room again. And again, she's going with like a heavier sound, kind of like, what is it I said in last ones? It was basically like, it's a bit like rock mixed with like, it's like electronic rock, you know? It's like the old band Orgy. Is what it reminds me of. It's got that, like, I don't know, it's just got a, it's a little bit heavy. It almost sounds like guitar, but it's almost like a digital guitar. I don't know, it's just weird, and the drums and stuff, but either way, weird in a good way. I like it because you never know what your ear is going to take in any second. Listen to this, boys. Every second of it, she's changing it up. She loves it. All right. I know that more. That was an awesome build-up, talking about her parents thinks that she's like totally strung out or something. And she's like, well, it doesn't matter because I'm rich as piss. I've never heard that saying before. I'm rich as piss. Okay, well, whatever. Boys, here's the thing, boys. She's basically saying, you know, when she smokes something, certain substance, her brunette comes out and she's starts going knuckin' futz. That's basically what she's saying, boys. Loves it, loves it. I think we have So I got a question now, is that... Okay, she's not stopping. Ooh, I like the way it works out, and she's lighting up at the end. All right, boys, here's the thing. Is she saying that whenever she lights up one of those things, she turns into Mary Jane Holland? Is that what she's getting on with? It's like a split personality or personality changes, because she did say that her brunette comes out and she starts going a bit crazy whenever, you know, when she lights up. Either way, that's what I got from it. Lyrics, cool lyrics, but at the same time, the song was super funky, very different. You never know where the sound's going to go. I don't know, loved it, boys, loved it. Comment down below, let me know what you think of this song. Let's get on to the next one, boys, let's go. All right, boys, moving on to Lady Gaga, Dope. Oh my God. Oh, my nerves. Look at the picture here. Sweet Testicle Tuesday. What the hell's happening on this one? Look at the outfit. Looks like something out of that game Little Nightmares I'm playing. You guys ever play that one? That's what it reminds me of. Jeez.
Quirks off, it's on. The party's just begun. I promise this. Drink is my last one. I know I fucked up again, 'cause I lost my only friend. God forgive my sins.
Impressive.
Don't leave me.
Trying to grasp the concept of the song. At first it sounded like she was singing about somebody she loves or somebody she misses, but then I'm like, oh, maybe she's singing about dope. Maybe she's singing about how much she loves dope and how much she misses being on drugs. But no, I don't think that's the premise, so we're going to keep listening to the lyrics now as we go. But okay, what a ballad. She's just, whenever Gaga sits in front of that piano, just her and the piano and her vocals, Body of Emotions comes out, and oh my God, it blows your freaking socks off.
I love you, stay with me, bell bottom blue. I'll keep on searching for an answer, 'cause I need you more than dope.
Oh.
I need you more than dope. Like coal, a mountain of his soul.
She's going through saying she loves you more than dope. She repeated that twice. Was that the purpose behind the song? She loves somebody more than dope, so she's having to give up dope to be with somebody that she loves. Because then she went on to talk about the 12-step programs and three spirits and all this kind of stuff. So maybe that's the whole premise. That's the vibe I'm getting, boys. Let me know if I'm right so far. The song ain't over, but basically that's the vibe I'm getting. Is she's addicted to the dope, but yet she's in a relationship. She loves the other person more than the dope, and she's trying to struggle to push the dope out because the other person don't like the dope or don't like the person who she is when she's on the dope, so she's trying to get rid of the dope. Oh my God, let's go.
Each day I cry. I feel so low from living high. My heart would break without you. Might not awake without you. Been hurt and low from living half a second long. I'm sorry and I love you. Stay with me, bell bottom blue. I'll keep on searching for an answer because I need.
Gaga, right, boys? Oh my Gaga, just like the friggin' shirt I'm wearing. Why? Because I gotta see a live version of this. You guys gotta recommend down below, is there a live version of her sitting in front of the piano pouring out her emotions about this song? And let me know, is this song anything she related to in real life? Did this actually happen, or is she just pulling on, like, you know, going down a rabbit hole she's never actually been down? Or did this actually happen in her life? Was she, like, you know, addicted to some types of drugs or alcohol or something, and then it infected a relationship she was in? That would be interesting, guys, to know. You guys comment down below and let me know.
For an answer, 'cause I need you more than no. I need you more than no. I need you more than dope.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Beautiful. I wasn't expecting that. This whole art pop album has been nothing but like super funk, super techno effects, and a bit of metal, a bit of rock and roll. Right? This song was totally different. This came out of nowhere. Out of all the songs, there's a totally different vibe than the rest of the album. Her just in the piano, pouring out her heart and emotions. Still singing about dope, though. A whole lot of songs about dopes and sex and sex and drugs and rock and roll in this album. That's pretty much how you sum up this album, isn't it? Art pop is sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Anyways, pretty freaking cool. Let's get on to the next one. Alright, boys, we're moving on to Lady Gaga, Gypsy. Now, I did hear Gypsy. Now, this is the one with the Muppets in it that I did. A while back, somebody recommended that I check out the Gypsy song with the Muppets, because I friggin' love Muppets. And either way, so I have heard the song before, but it was a live version, and it was probably going to sound different. So, rather than skip over it, I'm just going to throw it in here now, because I want to hear the official studio album version, not just her live singing with Kermit. Right, let's go.
Sometimes the story has no end.
I remember it being friggin'
sometimes
awesome.
Sometimes I think that we could just be friends. 'Cause I'm a wandering man, he said to me. And what about our future plans? Does the thing we have even make sense? When I got the whole world in front of me. So I said, I don't want to be alone forever, but I can be tonight. I don't want to be alone forever, but I love Gypsy life. I don't want to be alone forever.
Ooh, sounds
maybe
different
we
than
can
I remember.
See the world together. I don't want to be alone forever, but I can be tonight.
Ooh. This is what I remember now.
So I just packed my baggage and said goodbye to family and friends. And took a road to nowhere on my own.
Oh, I love this one. Now I remember. Now I remember. She took it up a notch. Boss, oh my God, I think Gypsy might be one of the best songs on this one. I don't know, one of the first couple songs were pretty good banging too. Any song that gets me friggin' hyped up dancing like that, I love it. But we're going back a little bit. We'll go back a little bit. Let's go.
Like Dorothy on a yellow brick. Woo. Hope my ruby shoes get us there quick.
Ruby shoes.
Cause I loved everyone, I love it all. And I don't wanna be alone forever, but I can be tonight. I don't wanna be alone forever, but I love Gypsy life.
How can you not? I love it. Never gets old. I don't know what I'm doing. Just having a good time. For her to drop out the beat and just go with her crystal clear angelic vocals like this. I'm not ready for it, boss. I'm not ready. I just lost control and then my arm started going in random directions, boys. I don't know what I was doing. It's almost like I needed glow sticks or something. Whatever, boys. I'm just feeling the music and moving, boys. And that's all you got to do when you listen to a Lady Friggin' Gaga song. Am I right? Of course I'm right. You know I'm right, boys. Okay. We're going to go back a little bit. We're going to brace ourselves. She fades the music away and she's just gonna sing to us, boys. She's just going to sing to us.
Then he asked me, he said, baby, why do we love each other? I said, honey, it's simple. It's the way that you love and treat your mother. Thought that I would be alone forever, but I won't be tonight. I'm a man without a home, but I think with you I could spend my life. And you'll be my little gypsy princess.
She's a gypsy, hey. Oh my God, Lady Friggin' Gaga. Oh my God, I forgot how banging that song was. All I remembered about it was her with the Muppets in it. That was friggin' awesome, and I loved everything about it, and I was dancing and sharing it, and I couldn't help myself either. So either way, loves this, boys, friggin' loves it. Why? Okay, first off, the lyrics she's singing about, is she basically singing about that her love for, like, traveling the world and friggin' being a musician on the road? That's basically what it is, because she's singing about her love for music. And then she starts naming all things over the world. Now, here's the thing. She says something like, I'm a man, but something like that. I'm a man, but I could find myself being in love with you as we travel on the road or something like that. So is that basically the premise of it? She's basically saying she's just happy if her life is complete and she's just happy as long as she's rocking out and traveling and seeing the whole world. That's why the end of song, I guess, starts naming all these different, like, places around the world, and she's just freaking stoked. Anyways, bang and beat, loves it, everything about it, makes you dance, makes you news. I know I'm not a good dancer, boys, but I don't care. When I feel the music, I just gotta move, boys. That's how it is. I hope you're doing the same thing when you're at home. All right, boys, ready to get into the last song of the album? Oh my God, here we go, let's go. All right, boys, so I just realized I've already done applause on this channel. I just put it on, like, I was like, this seems familiar. So then I, like, went on my channel, clicked an applause. I did this one a long time ago, back in the day, like a year ago or something. when I started my channel. So anyways, so rather than that, now just click typed in applause. It's the first one that came up. This is a live performance with the most views. So let's just check out a live performance of it. Why not? We're here now. Let's do it. Finish the album off right? It's been like a while since I heard this one. Those dancers are awesome. And then they go, and then they just start flailing like this. Oh my god. Is this the most popular song off this album? I feel like it is. I feel like this might be the more popular one. You guys can comment down below and let me know. But my god, these backup dancers. Hope you don't mind. I'm just going to be freaking dancing like the backup dancers. Oh my god, let's go. Okay, work it. Not doing that one. Shred it off. I guess, sir, if you say so, some of us just like to be. Ooh, okay. One second, I'm a coon's there. Suddenly, the coon's is me. They took her hat. Pop culture wasn't hard now. Words and pop culture in me. Oh. Oh my god, do you see these backup dancers? How coordinated are they? It's not like it's a straightforward, like they're just doing a few things. They're moving all over the place and intertwined. They're like choreographed, freaking synchronized swimmers, boys. You know what I'm talking about? Oh my god, they're freaking mind-blowingly talented. How many times did they have to rehearse this? And they're probably dancing all night during this live performance. Because this looks just like the other ones that I did where she came in that freaky white suit with the inflatables on. You know what I mean? Anyways. In the crowd. Security, save her.
Get off my fucking stage.
What? The height, the energy. Nobody does it. Work it. My god, is there a better performer? Oh my god, she's friggin' psycho and in the zone. Look at her. Psycho and in the zone. Sweet Testicle Tuesday, boys. Oh my gentle Gaga. Okay, here's the thing. Okay. That was intensity. She took, in the last 30 seconds, minute of that song, she took the intensity up a friggin' 1,000. she started going on. After she got up there, she's like, get off my effing stage. And the music comes in and she's friggin' rocking out, doing hand gestures and looking like a friggin' psycho. Oh my God, loved everything about it. There's no better performance. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. See, that's the thing. Why? I like checking out the studio albums just to hear the official audio, but I prefer to watch the live reactions. And in the past, I've done some live reactions and people complain saying, no, you got to check out the official audio so you can get the better sound and all this kind of stuff. So it's like, yeah, it's a turn up because just seeing her perform, there's nobody that can perform like her, and she's friggin' mind-blowing. Anyways, I ranted enough. What do we think of these last four songs on the Art Pop one? Friggin' flawless, 10 out of 10. Friggin' mind-blowing. Okay, now, if I had to pick a favorite one, I can't really remember because I gotta go back through them all, but it was one that was early. Let me quickly check. Let me go back. Go back to the Lady Gaga, right at the beginning. I can't remember. Can't remember which one it was. I don't know, it was one of those more metal ones. Swine is good, stands out to me. Gypsy, Applause. Guy's good. They're all freaking good. You know what? Come to think of it, they're all freaking flawless. Every one of them. All right. Anyways, I talk enough. Hope you guys enjoy this. I'll be getting on to the next album. What's the next album? What's the next album? I don't know. I'll figure it out. Whatever the next album is for Lady Gaga in order, that's the one we're going to be doing real soon. So if you got enjoyment of this video, be sure to hit the like button, guys. That's it for now. Thanks for watching New Reactions. Peace and love, everybody. Peace. I'll see you in the next one. All right. Take care. Bye-bye.